Let's take a simple question 4. Inventory cost is not specified directly. A manufacturer of control panels spent 34,000 per annum on purchasing activity. 67,200 are spent each year in maintaining inventory of ₹4.2 lakhs. Expenses referred above are only the variable portion of the total expenses. Around 850 orders are placed every year to replenish the stock of various items. One of the items whose annual consumption is 9,600 pieces is bought by the company at the rate of ₹30 each. The company has entered into an annual contract with a supplier of the item based on the staggered delivery. How much frequently should the company receive the staggered delivery in a what quantity? So the annual consumption is 9,600 units. Your P is, that is purchasing cost, comes out to be 34,000 divided by 850. Your unit cost is 30, and your cost comes out to be 67,200 divided by 4,20,000. That is 0.16. So putting it into equation, 2 into 9600 into 40 divide by 30 into 16 divide by 100, that is 1,60,000, and the square root of 1,60,000 is 400 units. So what are the inventory control techniques? Various specific inventory control techniques are employed by the organization within the framework of the basic inventory model. Example, fixed order quantity system or a fixed order period system. So most commonly used techniques are economic order quantity, maximum and minimum system, two bin systems, material requirement planning, and just in time. So objective of a scientific inventory control system, benefit to be achieved, to ensure improved and better services to the user, to keep capital tie-up at the minimum so that available capital is the most effectively used, to increase the inventory turnover ratio, to reduce the cost by taking best buying decision regarding when to buy and how much to buy, to improve management control so that remedial action is taken well before a particular situation develops, to reduce the risk due to obsolescence or deterioration, and so on, to ensure effective coordination between departments, and to develop inter-department harmony to increase the profit. So the modern concept of storekeeping should contribute directly to the profitability of a company and be concerned with such matters as flows, lead time, storage costs, acquisition costs, materials handling, open access methods, preservation, preparation, packing and dispatch. So determining the stock level, deficiency level, stock in hand is inadequate to meet the needs, exhaust bill level, buffer stock or a minimum stock, that is nothing but the insurance stock, danger warning stock level, precautionary measures, find an alternative source of supply, request the sales department in turn to inform the customer, inform the production personnel about the situation, revise the plan, put extra pressure on the supplier to keep to his original delivery schedule, reorder level of provisioning. So what is safety stock? That is a buffer stock. Safety stock to meet fluctuation in demand and lead time. So in order to guard against the situation of stock outs, it is essential to keep some extra stock, and these extra stocks are called as safety stocks. Safety stock under different situations, usage rate is uniform and lead time is steady, safety stock is equal to usage per period. When usage rate is variable but the lead time is steady, so safety stock is equal to maximum usage rate minus average usage rate multiplied by lead time. When both the usage rate and lead time vary, an average of for both are known. So safety stock is maximum possible usage minus normal usage, or maximum usage into maximum lead minus average usage into average lead. So let's go by a simple question. When the lead time varies between 60 days and 180 days with an average value of 90 days, and the usage rate varies between 70 units and 125 units per day with an average value of 100 units per day, calculate the safety stock required for the protection against the stock out. So the safety stock is maximum possible usage minus normal usage, and maximum usage into maximum lead time minus average usage, average lead time. So that is 125 multiplied by 180 minus 100 multiplied by 90, which comes out to be 13,500 units. Look at the second question also. For ABC company whose usage is 20 units per day, lead time needed to obtain the additional inventory when the order is placed in 60 days. Average quantity worked out by EOQ formula is 500 units, and if the stockout acceptance factor is kept at 1.2, work out the optimal reorder level. Now, reorder point is usage, lead time, average quantity order, and stockout acceptance factor. So if you look at the equation, is S into L plus F plus square root of SRL. So in other words, S is usage, 20 units per day, L is the lead time, 60 days, R is the average quantity order, 500 units, and F is stockout acceptance factor is 1.2. So when you equate this, that is 20 into 60 plus 1.2 plus square root of 20 into 500 into 60 comes out to be 1200 plus 1.2 into 774.6, which comes out to be 2129.5. So that's 2130. So once you deliver safety stock or optimal safety stock, following formula can be used to obtain different level of inventory. So reorder level is normal consumption plus safety stock. Maximum inventory level is order quantity plus safety stock. Minimum inventory level is nothing but the safety stock. And average inventory is half time order quantity plus